السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. This is Hani Ismail from Planning Engineer website. In this lesson, we are going to discuss a very interesting topic, which is the recovery schedule. Recovery schedule is very important schedule. Usually, we have to do it at certain stage in the project, because as the project life cycle goes on, problem happens, and when problem happens, delay happens. That means if your project is late and your forecast finish date is later than the planned date, which is the baseline date, then you have to create a recovery schedule. So we break delays causes into main categories: delays because of the contractor, and delays not fault of the contractor, could be owner, consultant, or something force majeure. So our recovery schedule should be created whenever a delay is caused by the contractor. But let's talk about the delays happen when the contractors don't follow the plan. We will find planned percentage is more than actual percentage, usually, but not necessarily, because you might have the actual percentage more than the planned. However, the most important thing is the forecast completion date. If your forecast completion date is beyond the planned finish date, then you need to do a recovery schedule. On the other hand, if the delay is caused by the owner or the consultant because of the new scope of work or suspension period or whatever, then you will do a revised plan, not a recovery plan. So before diving into the recovery schedule, let's see the differences between recovery plan and revised. The recovery plan, the project finish date doesn't change, so you are recover something. You are recovered delays, and you would like to bring back the forecast finish date to the baseline finish date. The recovery plan, the delay is because of the contractor. It is a contractor fault, not the client fault. So that's why we are going back to our finish date. A schedule is formally submitted for review. No claims, no compensations. And don't worry about claim and compensations, because we have another lesson for this area. On the other hand, the revised plan, which we'll discuss in detail next lesson, the project finish date could be changed, delayed not because of the contractor, a schedule should be also submitted for review, and we could have some claims and prolongation costs because of these additional periods. So recovery plan, the contractor should submit if the project has recorded delays. Maybe if you are going to change your phasing plan, for example, you are going to work in another scenario than submitted in the baseline, in that case you should submit a recovery plan. So to make it short, the recovery plan, you changing the project remaining activities to meet the contractual obligations and to meet the contractual deadline. So from this photo, can you tell the situation of the project based on this data? We have here a project, we have here baseline project start, we have here the actual start, we have here baseline project finish, and we have here the finish call. From this snapshot, I can tell that the project plan to start 1st January 2024, and it is already started in 1st January 2024, since there is a letter beside the date. The contractual finish date or the baseline finish date is 26 September. However, the forecast finish date is 1st October. How I knew that this is a forecast date, not actual, because there is no a letter beside the date. If you don't see the lesson for how to read Primavera time schedule, I highly recommend to go back and check this lesson. Okay, so forecast finish date is greater than baseline finish date. It means the project is delayed. As I mentioned earlier, you might see the planned percentage and the actual percentage does not tell the whole story. So you need to see also the planned finish date and the forecast finish date. As long as no scope is added or any variation orders are issued, the contractor is responsible for these delays. He has to prepare a recovery plan to mitigate those delays. Mentioning the recovery plan and mitigation, there are two ways to do recovery scheduling I would like to tell you about. We can use crashing, we can use fast tracking. These are the main two techniques when you are doing the recovery schedule. Simply crashing from its name, I'm reducing the duration of the activity. While the fast tracking, I'm working in parallel in the activities. Each scenario or each methodology had its pros and cons. For example, crashing will increase the cost because you will have some productivity loss when you make operation is less, and you might have some risks of idle manpower if you plan to finish, for example, the machinery in some certain period which is short, and you already prepared and mobilized the plaster team. They can have some ideal days because the machinery team didn't finish their work. On the other hand, the fast tracking might increase the risks because you might be working in same area for different activities at the same time. Okay, so we have here this normal scenario. We have activity one, then we have activity two. Fast tracking will have activity one and will start activity two before completing activity 100% to gain time. So what happened here? We reduce the project duration from this point to this point. Crashing will reduce the duration for activity one and activity two and will complete the project at this point. So creating a recovery schedule, the question is, what are the steps? First of all, we need to prepare two versions of the schedule, one updated and one is a baseline. Then we check what are the delayed activities in the updated schedule. Here, let me tell you one important thing. I see many planners, they consider the updated version of the baseline schedule and they consider it as a recovery schedule with actuals. This will cause some issues later on in the forecasting of percentages and days. In my school, I prefer to have recovery schedule without updates. But what I'm trying to do here is to bring the planned date as near as the updated version. So what we'll do here, we will check that the delayed activity in the updated schedule, and we will modify the delayed activity dates to match the actual status in the baseline version. So here, for example, we have here a delayed activity. So we will go back to the baseline and fix this activity and let it to be completed in the forecast finish date in the baseline version. In the baseline, modify the delayed activity dates to match the actual status. Then we will check that the baseline dates forecast finish will be completed on time. In this baseline, we'll go to the machinery activity and we will add 2 days lag to the relationships. So we'll push it 2 days because in the updated schedule here, it was delayed 2 days. So this is how simple it is. This is the concept of doing the recovery schedule. As we agreed in our course, this is the basics of project management. However, I would like to know, think about everything. That's why I'm telling you some technical information how to do things. And if you are interested to know more about this one, we have a specialized courses. So after we moved the delayed or the activity that is delayed in the update, then we will update our time schedule. Adding lag is very simple. You click on the activity and here from the lag, you can add the 2 days lag. Also, we can change the duration of the activity to make the finish date match the update finish date, which was before 12 June. So now we check if the baseline finish date equal to the update finish date. If this is the case, then we are done. Here we have the finish date is 1st October. So now the finish date of the baseline equal to the delayed finish date. Now what we need to do, we need to start crashing or fast tracking or maybe both the activities that haven't started, because the activity with no start I can control, but the activity already started I can do nothing. So in our example here, we can go to the firefighting system and start reducing the duration or doing some crashing or fast tracking. By doing this, I'll be sure that the forecast finish date of the not started activity will match the date of our baseline. So it is very simple to create the recovery schedule. Now when I check the finish date of the project, it should be same as the baseline schedule. As we agreed, all our videos, these presentations are available for your download. You will find always a course link in the description, and you can go to the relevant lesson number. For example, this lesson video lesson number, you will find the same number in the website. You can enroll free in the course and you can download the course content. So the version of the schedule after that duration modified is called a recovery schedule. Once you did the recovery schedule, it should be officially submitted with a narrative report to the consultant or the client to tell them what you did. And the narrative report is important here because you would like to tell the reader what you have done, and don't rely on their exercise to find out what you have done. The schedule we created will consider now as our new baseline. It should be updated in weekly or monthly basis, and you keep monitoring it. The first step we do after creating a recovery schedule is to update the schedule with the latest progress update. And this is a very important step to be done before submitting your schedule for approval. Because if the recovery schedule, after the update, if the plan is less than or equal to the actual, then you are okay. If the plan is more than the actual, this is not a good scenario. You need to adjust the relationship in the recovery schedule by doing this step again and keep it checking. Let's see an example of what I mean. I don't mean exactly the same. It shouldn't be some minor variance. It is acceptable. In this scenario, the schedule percentage complete or the plan is 55.09. The performance percentage complete or the actual is 54.22. It means once you update the schedule, you will be behind by 0.9. I don't recommend this scenario. I need you to go and maybe the variance will be 0.1, 0.05, something like that. But 0.9, to be honest, is too much. So the contractor now should check the schedule and adjust the relationship and update again to see the variance. Once the actual percentage is more than or equal to the planned percentage, you are okay and you can submit the recovery schedule to be up. I tried in this video to give you the recovery schedule in short and simple terms. As this course purpose, you need only to know the concept of the recovery schedule. If you are interested to know more about recovery schedule, or you are interested in the planning field, you are welcome to check our other courses. Thank you very much for watching this lesson. I hope you find it useful to you. See you in the next one.